granted by God's servant, our beloved pastor in the words of Brother Victor, our darling pastor, in my own words, Pastor Milex. Thank you for the opportunity. God's gracious upon you in the name of Jesus Christ. It's been such an honor serving under you, because many times we come with decisions, we are short-sighted, but his vision, every of his decisions are usually for posterity. What will happen after now? Where will we live? Hallelujah. I ask that God will continue strengthening you and energizing you in the name of Jesus Christ. And for the leadership of the church, privilege. Thank you so much. God bless us all in the name of Jesus Christ. And as Deacon Jeremy taught us, and my darling one. God bless. Hallelujah. You know, the time she said yes, I didn't have any form of comeliness that you should behold me. But she saw vision. Thank you. God bless you, Mama. Hallelujah. Very shortly, we go into Thanksgiving practicals. Hallelujah. Praise God. For the kingdom of God is not about talk, it's about action, doing. Praise God. So it's just a charge. I'm just like John the Baptist. I'm a forerunner. God's servant will be coming shortly. The priest will be continuing what they are doing. It's just a few words to charge us up, to know why we are doing what we do. And God will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Thanksgiving practical. And that's Thanksgiving demonstrated. Some of us, when we were in school, some of us did agric science in school. Agric science in your bachelor's, right? In your O-level. Forgive me. We did agree. After you learn about the maize, you learn about the banana, there's a day you come and write exam, it's called Agri Practicals. Praise God. Are we together? And so our medical students too, you go, they teach you plenty theory, the day comes, it's medicine practical. Praise God. And we are scientists in the lab, they teach us a lot of things in the class. Those of us at school in Africa, some of us are engineers, we've never seen the equipment, so we're imagining it. But when we came to China, it became engineering practical. So today is Thanksgiving practical. Are we together? Hallelujah. And so these are the lectures, because this is the school of the spirit. Our conference is the school of the spirit we are in. We are not just learning for the sake of theory, it's things to practice. Praise God. And our first lecture on Thanksgiving, spiritual lecture now, because we're in the school of the spirit, and we know that it was the spirit of scripture where he said Paul was teaching in the school of one Tyrannus. So that we're in school is common in the kingdom, hallelujah, but it's the school of the spirit. So our first lecture was faith in thanksgiving. That's thanking God in advance. Are we together? We will do practicals today. Then the duty of giving thanks is our responsibility to give thanks. We do that responsibility today. Hallelujah. And then there's abounding in thanksgiving. That is, we should be rich in thanksgiving. We do practicals today. And then the radiance of God's glory. All our hallelujah, all our dancing is because of this gift that God gave us, the radiance of God's glory. So we just run through thanksgiving practicals. God help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Next slide, sir. Okay, sorry. It's here. Forgive me. Praise God. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. So practical. A class or exam or any scientific technical subject in which students do things rather than just write or talk about them. That's the definition of practicals in Cambridge Dictionary. Okay. So, therefore, whatsoever, and this is scripture now, you say, therefore, whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken unto a wise man which built his house upon a rock. We've been taught about thanksgiving. But the wise man is not the one that learns about thanksgiving, he's the one that doeth thanksgiving. Hallelujah. Next slide, sir. Sorry, we rush. It's just introduction. But whosoever looketh into this perfect law of liberty and continueth therein, he be not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of this work, this man shall be blessed in his deed. So what God blesses is not the hearing. We are familiar just with vision. Hallelujah. It is in the doing. Praise God. So today's goal is not to talk on thanksgiving, but to give God quality thanks. Thanksgiving practical. Hallelujah. And somebody say, but what we have been taught is for our lives. It's not just for Sunday service, it's for a lifestyle. You know, when we come into God's presence, God fills us with joy and we export the joy. Hallelujah. Many times in my life, my personal testimony, now when I come to NCC, they will just sing a song. I want to sing a song, but one day on a Wednesday, on a Thursday, that's the song that wakes me up. Hallelujah. That deposit was given when I came to the sanctuary. Hallelujah. So today, as we praise God, the oil of gladness, the oil of joy, the garment of praise is going to clothe us. And it means bye-bye to depression in the coming year, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Because we are going to be clothed with the garment of praise, the oil of gladness. God will give us songs. Hallelujah. And as we praise him, it gets engraved in our spirit and our joy. And you know, there are many things that joy does. God will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Next slide, sir. So, why thanks? Why are we giving thanks? Why are we giving thanks? Familiar scripture. Psalm 103, verse 1 to 9. Help us with that text. Psalm 103, verse 1 to 9. We just reasons. Some of us will be wondering, why are we giving thanks? Okay. Psalm 103. Sorry. Psalm 103. Plus one to nine. Praise God. Sorry, I talk fast. It's not. Forgive me. Praise God. Are we together, please?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Okay. Why should we open it up? Okay. Can we go together? Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless His holy name. Next verse. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits. What did He do? Let's go. Who forgiveth all thy iniquities? Who healeth all thy diseases? Hallelujah. Next, we're going to 9. Who redeemeth our life from destruction? Who crowneth us with loving kindness and tender mercies? Next. Who satisfied our mouths with good things, so that our youth is renewed like the eagles? Next. The Lord executed righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed. Next. He made known His ways to Moses, His acts to the children of Israel. Next. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and plenteous in mercy. Verse 9. He will not always chide, neither will He keep His anger forever. Hallelujah. So why are we giving thanks? We're stopping there. Okay. Why are we giving thanks? The slide. So we just run through these things, okay? Sorry, we are short of time. That one said I'm short of words. We are short of time. Hallelujah. Because of the following. That's why all these things are made available because of the radiance of God's glory, what Jesus did for us. Are we together? We are not going over the things we have done before. We want to do practicals. Hallelujah. So, first, we are thanking God for forgiveness, made possible by the radiance of God's glory. We are thanking God for healing. Some of us, we fell down in sickness, but we are up again. Who did that? Jesus. Some went down, they didn't come up. We are thanking God for healing. Hallelujah. The flu has been running around. Praise God. And we prayed for somebody, me and a friend, we prayed for somebody concerning the flu on Friday. In the morning of Saturday, my voice changed. Hallelujah. So it's like the flu was looking for who. So my wife said I should come with hanky. I said, no, it cannot rest on me. It can try, but it cannot rest. It's not possible because of the radiance of God's glory. Not anybody. Praise God. It doesn't mean that it won't try. It will try. It may try for 4 days, you know. But it will go away. It's sure. Hallelujah. God will grant you understanding in the name of Jesus Christ. So next, we're thanking God for good things. Good things. Some of us, on the 14th of December, our brother, Bro Victor, he came into 2019 as one company. He's crossing out as two company. Good things. Hallelujah. And all of us hope our own good things. Hallelujah. So deliverance from destruction. Do you know the meeting the enemy is doing on our head? On your head? But because of God. And that's how verse 1:7. If it had not been the Lord that had been on our side, let MCC say, put your name there. Let Oluwafemi say, hallelujah. So we are thanking God for deliverance from destruction, for crowning us with loving kindness and mercy. Now you will notice that the word mercy came over and over and again. Praise God. And verse now in Genesis 3, say that not in the Lord mercy. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
He didn't come, but Lamentation chapter 3 verse 22. If that not in the Lord, I did not aside, but as in His mercy, they fear not. It is evident. It's messy. Sorry, that's how I remember. Forgive me. Praise God. So, Lamentation 3. Then in Psalm 136, he said, He slew great kings because His mercy endured forever. Of the king of Bashan, His mercy endured forever. He brought us from our country, His mercy endured forever. Gave us food, mercy endured. Every good thing He did because His mercy endured forever. So, why are we giving thanks? In all this, is because His mercy endured forever. Yes. Hallelujah. So, thanking Him for who He is. God is good and His mercy endured forever. So anytime we thank Him because He is good and His mercy endured forever, we shift to the realm of praise. Praise God. That's why we are praising today. We are praising for who He is. Praise God. And one way He is He's good and His mercy endured forever. And those are just scriptural texts too, of people who praised Him and said thank you because He is good and His mercy endured forever. Next slide. Praise God. So there are three categories of people that are going to praise. You can be in all of them, you can be in two of them, you can be in one of them. But these are the group of people that want to give God thanksgiving practically today. Want to do thanksgiving practicals. There are three classes of people. You find your place, and everybody must thank God because you are in one of these classes. Hallelujah. Let's go, sir. First, have you seen God's hand and miracles this year?
Yes.
Is there somebody who has seen God's hand and miracles this year?
Yes.
Remember this. For they got not the land in possession by their own sword, neither did their own arm save them, but thy right hand and thy arm, and the light of thy countenance, because thou hast a favor unto them. Praise God. So the good is because of Him. Praise God. Have you seen God's good word? Or you were the one who, through your hand, God did mighty things. You know, you were the Samson, not the one that fell. This one is the Samson that stays up. Hallelujah. You were the Samson. God used you as Samson this year. No. God wrote all our works in us. Even the ones that he did through us, it was him that wrote it in us. And then verse 3 said, it's God that worked it in us, both to will and to do. So whether it appears God did it directly or it appears you are the one doing it, it is still God. Not by power, not by might, but by my spirit, said the Lord. And then in James chapter 1, verse 17, it says, every good and perfect gift comes from God. Hallelujah. So to the first class of people, you've seen God's goodness. This is why you should give thanks. Because it's not about you, it's because of him. If not because of him. Where I for thee, where I for thee, Jesus know that for me. That's one song. Then there's this song, absolutely nothing without you. All I am is what you gave me. All I am is what you made me. I'm absolutely nothing without you. Absolutely nothing without you. So everything we are is because of him. Hallelujah. So we give thanks. This is the first class of people. First class of people. You have seen God's will. Next class. Or are you someone who have things been rough or challenging? Or you falling? You know, some of us, thank God for the good news, but some of us, the year was not as easy. Praise God. It was tough. It was tough. It was tough. I just have this word for you that all things are working together for your good. All things are working together for my good. It may not look like it, but all things are working together. Hallelujah. And someone says, but me, I'm falling. You know, I used to be on fire for God. We had a wonderful testimony of God, what God did in the life of one of us in prayer yesterday. You know, the year 2019 was the year of sowing in the spirit. Hallelujah. But some of us, our own may not be like that. We fell down. If you give God the chance today, just relax. He will restore your story. Because Jonah in the Bible, Jonah willingly disobeyed God. God said, go here. He went the other way. Praise God. Who disobeyed? Jonah. Did he receive help? He willingly disobeyed. And then when he fell into the water, a whale came and, we are familiar with the story, right? A whale came and swallowed him for 3 days. Now you will find out that even in Jonah's disobedience, he was fulfilling God's mandate. Because when Jesus was going to come, among all the proverbs and the parables that Jesus would say, it was Jonah's case, Jesus would say, he said, even as Jonah was in the belly of the fish for 3 days, that is how the Son of Man will rise up. What am I saying? Did you fall down? Even in that you're falling down, if we accept and come back to God today, that's your story. God uses it to beautify generations. That is why we should give thanks. That is why we should give thanks. Oh, why? As in, things are still challenging. God is with you. God is with you. That's why we should give thanks, because God is with you. And then remember Joseph. His brothers did all the evil they could do against him. There was nothing they didn't do. But in prison, God was with him. In Potiphar's house, God was with him. Then, you know, there's a way human beings see, there's a way God sees. They thought they sent him away. When God was going to come and give, or they thought they punished him, or they thought they wanted to kill him, God's report said in Psalm 105 verse 17. Psalm 105 verse 17. Okay? It's like, I don't want to be quoting so that this is cool, so that we know what's happening. Psalm 105 verse 17, we just take that blue. It's the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Sorry. Let me just go. Okay. He said, the brethren thought they did him punishment. This was God's opinion. He sent a man before them, even Joseph, who was sold for a servant. So they thought they were punishing him, but God sent him. What am I saying? You are here, things are changing, things are not going. It appears as if the devil means you. I'm here to tell you today, because God would say so. It is God working for good. God sent you. That situation, in the end of the story, they will know that actually God sent him. That will be our testimony in the name of Jesus Christ. And sorry, we are still there, sir. Okay? And some of us, the battles are too much. The enemies have raged. They vowed that they will cut us off. There's nothing they didn't vow. I'm here to tell you that God is for you. If God be for me, who can be against me? Hallelujah. And so that we don't think his story. It happened in the life of Esther. Haman vowed that he was going to deal with Mordecai. He was going to kill him. But you know what God did? And he didn't just come naturally. He went and consulted witches and wizards. And said, I will cut Mordecai down and say, but God was for him. Okay, I spoke my language for Hallelujah. But on the serious note, okay? So God was for him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God was for him. So because God was for him, he replaced the man that was against him. On the seat, he replaced the man that was against him. And the man that wanted to kill him, both the man and all his children were killed. Praise God. Why? Because God was for him. So are you here? Battered, things have not been okay. I'm here to tell you that all things are working to you for your good. God is with you. God is for you. And lost one encouragement to someone who's going through something. You know the devil is very wicked, right? He's against us Christians. Are we not so? It's not so. It's true now. But in Colossians chapter 1, verse 16, you know what the Bible says? All things were made by him and for him. Even the devil is working for God. So that thing he's doing against your life, he's doing it for your good. So then you will come to a place that nothing can ever be done against the blessed man except for the blessed man. Even that most unpalatable situation is for you. Nothing can successfully be done against you. No matter how vile, how wicked, how tough, it is still for you. You know why? Because God is for you. God will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. So that when we are dancing, you will not look at your situation. You will remember God is for me. God is for me. Are we together? So that's second class of you. Third class, we are about going. Hallelujah. Are we going together, please? Hallelujah. Then, first people, God is good. Second people, well, God is good, but it didn't appear as though. Then the third class of people, do you want to see God's manifold hand in 2020? Yes. Practice faith in thanksgiving. Praise God. And so we have Judah, we're going for war. Israel, we're going for the war. They asked God, who should go first? They said Judah went first against the Canaanites and Benjamin. So praise went first. Thanksgiving went first. And when thanksgiving went first, the enemies were defeated. Then again, when Israel were crossing, they wanted to go and face Jericho. They went around 7 times, right? On the 7th day they came, and when they were going to get their victory, they were directed to blow the trumpet, and they made a shout. And what happened to Jericho? Jericho crashed. You know why? Praise and thanksgiving went first. You want the Jericho of 2020 to crash? Practice shouting today. Practice thanksgiving. Are we together, please? Then we see in Acts chapter 16, that's the typo. It's 25 to 40. Paul and Silas were in the prison. Familiar story. Nothing to laugh about. Nothing to be happy about. But in the midst of the fire, as I love to say, they raised the hallelujah. Praise God. And what happened? They came out. Time will fail us, but I've come by research to find out that, you see, Paul and Silas were arrested here. Because they praised, they were delivered. If you follow the text, they didn't come and say, they came and begged them to go out. Finish the story. They embarrassed them, but they came and begged them. How many of us remember that Peter was kidnapped at the point in time? Peter, remember? When Peter was kidnapped, they prayed. They didn't praise and give thanks. Peter was rescued, but Peter had to run away. Because when the angel left him, he took him there, he greeted them, and he ran to the next city. But when this one's praised, this was how they came out. Triumphant victory. That's what praise does. And this is not just one example. Because also in the story of Judah, in 2 Corinthians chapter 20, verse 19. 2 Corinthians chapter 20, verse 19 is there. Hallelujah. Israel, we're going for war because we want to praise, we want to do thanksgiving practices. It's not a day of talk. That's why we're rushing. Hallelujah. So in 2 Corinthians chapter 24, verse 19 to 24, we find out that they wanted to go for war. They sent the Levites. It was praises that went first for them. Hallelujah. And if you go to verse 24, he said, none of the adversaries escaped. Praise God. And so shall it be as we praise God from the depth of our hearts today. Every opposition, none of them will escape in the name of Jesus Christ. Because our praise will go forward for us in the name of Jesus Christ. And also to compare that with prayer, there are other kings in Israel. Well, time will fill me. But they had a challenge and they prayed. We had a story that God sent his angel and 185,000 people were taken away, but they still remained. 185 were killed, but they were still remaining. But in the case of praise, none escaped. I want us to know why we are celebrating God. So when we begin to dance, we know why. God will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Next slide. I think we're almost there. Praise God. Praise God. And so, thanksgiving practicals. So how did they do it, those that did it? Now, recall, everything is written for our example. For whatever things are written aforetime, we are written for our learning, that we may, through patience and comfort of scriptures, might have hope. Remember your leaders. I'm quoting scripture now. Are we together? Are we on the slide? Remember your leaders who spoke the word of God to you. Consider the outcome of their life and imitate their faith. Imitate means copy and paste their faith. Exactly as they did it. What did they do? They put their leg. You too, put your leg. That's what that scripture says. Imitate their faith. Why? Because Jesus the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. If he did it before, he will do it again. Same God back then. He did it before. Same God right now, same God back then. Hallelujah. Then that, and this is Apostle Paul's charge to us. He said, that which we have seen and heard, declare we unto you, that he also may have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. So this was Apostle Paul speaking. These things I'm speaking to you, okay? I'm not speaking it so that you learn. So that you have the same experience we have, the same fellowship. You have fellowship with these things we're talking about. That's why I'm speaking them to you. So if we see what they did and we do what they did, we will see what they saw. Are we together? Okay. Please, let's get the message. I'm not trying to, no. If we do what they did, if we see what they did, we do what they did, we will see what they saw. Praise God. And so just copy and paste. Why? Because Jesus did say. So that's why I want to practicalize what they did. So what did they do? How did they do it? Which is what we're going to do. No. Not tomorrow. Right now. Hallelujah. Next. Are we being blessed? Hallelujah. Next slide. Okay. So how did they do it then? Recall also we have to give thanks. Okay, so Israel sang and danced. That, we are talking about action they did. David danced with all his might. So if I sing a song and you are doing like this. David, how did David do it? With all his might. Jehoshaphat and Israel, they blew trumpets and they sang. Paul and Silas sang. The Hebrew believers, they gave the fruit of their lips. Lord, there's no one like you. Your house song. They wrote a poem for God. That was how they did their own. Then we found about Jesus. Jesus said, Father, I thank you. So even Father, I thank you is accepted. Oh, hallelujah. But we want to do practicals. And the reason is that as we do it here today, the spirit of joy, the garment of peace, will follow us to our room and trample to our treaty in the name of Jesus Christ. Next slide, sir. So, as we are doing all this dancing and praising God now, we are not doing it for doing sake. What should we expect? What should we expect? Because our God is not the man that should lie. As we do it, his word is true. This is what the Bible says, not the Bible says it. What the Bible says. Hallelujah. I know God sent his servant, Pastor Milex, to us. And Pastor Milex sent me to you. Okay? And I'm telling you that as we do what they did, we will see what they saw. And what did they do? We found out the sun. Now, what did they see? So that we expect to see it here. Hallelujah. Praise God. Now, we expect the impartation with the oil of joy and clothing with the garment of praise. Praise God. I've talked about that. Hallelujah. Isaiah chapter 6, 1 verse 3. Long, last Sunday, as Pastor was talking, talked about the reigns of God's glory. As in this, he said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, he has anointed me. One of the things that anointing to is to give exchange of our oil of gladness and give us garment of praise. Hallelujah. Because of time. Sorry, we want to praise God. Then he will perfect our blessings. During the month, we've learned about the 10 lepers. Jesus was taking roll call. Were they not 10 that were cleansed? You know roll call. You know, it's a practical exam. Were they not 10? Only one came. He's the only one that has marks. He was made whole. He was made whole. Hallelujah. I'm not trying to be funny. I'm just saying what scripture is saying. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. So, okay. So we expect perfection of our blessings. I get things God has started in our life. In 2019, as we dance and praise God, we expect God to perfect it today in the name of Jesus Christ. Then multiplication of our blessings of past years. Hallelujah. He said, let the people praise him, let the people praise him. Then shall the earth yield her increase. Psalm 67, verse 5 to 6. And in Matthew chapter 15, verse 36 to 37. It's an example of the God Jesus wanted to feed 5,000. No, 4,000. There were 7 loaves and 2 fish. You will catch me that I didn't attend this memory. That thing is correct. Okay, so you find out that what did Jesus do? He gave thanks and it was multiplied. As we give thanks today and dance as they did, I expect us to see multiplication. What's more, I expect us to access God's voice. Some of us are trusting God for direction for 2020, but God is not around depression. He wants joy. As you are celebrating God, expect him to give you direction. Concerning your business, concerning your school, concerning your studies. These are things to expect. And expect it now, not tomorrow. Because it's Thanksgiving practice. Hallelujah. So we expect to hear God's voice. And the practical example is Acts chapter 13, verse 1 to 2. Acts 13, 1 to 2. Okay, it says, where they gathered and they worshiped, the Holy Spirit said. And in Isaiah chapter 30, verse 29 to 30. Isaiah 30, 29, 30. God said, he said, you should raise a song. He said, then God will cause his glorious voice to be heard. We will hear his voice today in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. What else should we expect as we dance and praise God today? We expect to contact wisdom and direction. God has spoken about that. Hallelujah. And in Isaiah chapter 12, verse 3, he said, with joy shall you draw out of the wells of salvation. In Proverbs chapter 20, verse 5, he talks about the fact, he said, counsel in the heart of a man is deep, but the man of understanding will draw it out. How will you draw it? By joy. Praise God. And as give God thanks, joy envelopes us. And then counsel begins to come. That will be our experience in the name of Jesus Christ. What else should we expect as we raise our shout? Parting of barriers before us. Parting of barriers. Every opposition as we raise our shout, the way they raised it, that Jericho parted. The way they entered the Jordan and Jordan parted. Can we just read that scripture last week? Psalm, we're about to go into practicals. Psalm 114, verse 1 to 8. That's where we're going. Everybody, can we just go together? said, when Israel went out of Egypt, the house of Jacob from a people of strange language, yes? He said, Judah was his sanctuary. Judah talks about praise, yes? Judah, praise was his sanctuary. Okay? And Israel is dominion next. He said, the sea saw it and fled. Jordan was driven back. Let's stop there. When they went with praise, the Jordan was asked, okay, next one. He said, the mountains keep like rams. Next. He said, then they were asking the Jordan, they were asking the opposition to you and to me, what did you see that made you to run? They now say, what ailed thee? Oh, thou see that thou fled, thou Jordan that thou was driven back. Here's the answer. Why did he flee? The opposition will flee. Next up. We flee because ye mountains that you skip like rams. Next. Tremble thou, earth, at the presence of the Lord. And you know God inhabits the praise of his people. Say, thou art one that inhabits the praise of his people. So as we praise God to the slides, as we praise God and dance today, let's expect to experience these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Expectation is the beginning of everything. With no expectation, we won't receive nothing. But we say these things so that we know. Everybody has a reason to praise. And when we praise, this is what we say to the slides. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's practical time. It's practical time. Come, the priest team, can we come, please? It's time for practical so that we know when we lift our hands, why are we doing what we are doing? God will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody has been blessed by this word. Can you just lift up your hands? Lord God, as I practicalize, yes, as I practicalize praise. Hallelujah. As I practicalize praise, let me see what they saw in the name of Jesus Christ. I will hand over the mic to praise and worship team. But before that, we are going to read the scripture together, everybody. Psalm 149, verse 1 to 9. That's our text. Praise God. Psalm 119, verse. Everybody, please come right on. Okay, we won't sing. Let's just finish reading it. Let's participate. God will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Can we go together? Praise ye the Lord. Sing unto the Lord a new song. And his in the confession of sins. Let MCC rejoice in him that made him. Let the children of MCC be joyful in their king. Next. Let them praise his name in a dance. Let them sing praises unto him with timbrel and harp. Next. For the Lord taketh pleasure in his people. He will beautify the meek with salvation. Next. Let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud upon their beds, upon the sixth floor. Next. Let the high praises of God be in their mouth and a two-edged sword in their hand to execute vengeance upon the hidden and punishment upon the people. Next. To bind their kings with chains and their nobles with fetters of iron. To execute judgment upon them. The judgment written. This honor is for all the saints. And as we shout one hallelujah, as I hand over the mic to praise as they lead us in that session. I see all these things happening in our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody give Jesus a shout! Thank you.